This tutorial shows you how to conduct a candle tau rank correlation in R. First, it is important to note that three different candles tau exist, A, B and C. Candles tau A is to be ignored, because it does not control for ties. Candle tau B, however, does and is the default within the cor.test function, which I will show first. If you have different scales, for example a 5 and a 7 point Likert scale, you might want to use candles tau C, also known as Stewart tau C, which I will show a bit later as well. Let's start with candles tau B and the already mentioned cor.test function. No additional packages are needed and you can start right away. Remember the requirement of at least ordinal scaled variables for the candle tau correlation. Add the two variables you want to correlate into the cor.test function, separated by commas. Don't forget the data frame and the dollar sign in front of each. Candle tau B will be calculated only when you add method equals and within quotation marks candle. By default, testing will be two-sided, meaning you are not sure whether to expect a positive or a negative correlation. If you are testing one-sided, you can specify the alternative hypothesis here with alternative equals. Use greater within quotation marks if you expect a correlation greater than zero, aka a positive correlation. Use less in quotation marks if you expect a correlation less than zero, aka a negative correlation. Please be aware that an exact p-value is computed if there are less than 50 observations and no ties. Otherwise, an approximate p-value is calculated. I will run the two-sided calculation now, even though I could justify testing one-sided. Please also note that both of my variables are above the ordinal scale level, which is of course fine for a candle tau rank correlation. The output will reveal the p-value at the top. Furthermore, you will get your correlation coefficient at the bottom. First, I'll focus on the p-value. If your p-value is below the predefined threshold, for example 0.05, the null hypothesis can be rejected. Reminder, the null hypothesis assumes no correlation, neither positive nor negative between your two variables. In my example, I defined alpha as 0.05 and can therefore reject the null hypothesis, because my rounded p-value for a two-sided test is 1.94 times 10 to the negative 7. Note, the one-sided p-value will always be half of the two-sided p-value, in case you specify the correct alternative hypothesis. Second, the correlation coefficient should be looked at. Here it is 0.514. A positive correlation can therefore be observed, meaning you have a positive association between height and weight. This could mean that either taller human beings are heavier or the other way around. Keep in mind that correlation does not imply causation. Furthermore, a small p-value does not tell you about the magnitude of the correlation, aka effect. The magnitude of the correlation is the correlation coefficient itself. Compare it with existing studies or use research field-specific thresholds to classify your correlation coefficient. If neither exists, you can fall back to Cohen 92, a power primer, and use these thresholds on page 157, 0.1, 0.3 and 0.5 for small, medium and large effect sizes. My correlation of 0.514 is barely above the threshold of 0.5, still making it a large effect. I will now briefly show the calculation of Stewart tau C or candle tau C. Load the DescTools package and use the Stewart tau C function. You only need to add your two variables. The interpretation is the same as with candles tau B. A final note, if you need confidence intervals for tau B, use candle tau B and also the conf.level argument of the DescTools package. To get a p-value for candles tau C and keep this video more concise, please refer to the following video.